You're listening to PetLifeRadio.com.
I'm Seth Peterson.
I am Debbie Hedren.
I'm Rhonda Schwartz.
I'm Doris Roberts.
This is Jesslyn Gilson.
Hello, I'm Victor Webb.
Hi, this is Charlotte Ross.
Hi, this is Ed Begley Jr.
What's up, you guys? This is AJ from the Backstreet Boys.
Hi, this is Shannon Elizabeth, and you're listening to Talkin' Pets.
Talkin' Pets.
Talkin' Pets. And you're listening to Talkin' Pets.
Talkin' Pets.
Talkin' Pets.
With Jon Patch.
Jon Patch.
You're listening to Talkin' Pets with Jon Patch.
Hello, America, and welcome to Talkin' Pets with your host, Jon Patch. Join Jon and his expert guests with all of your pet questions, concerns, comments, and stories. Now it's time for Talkin' Pets with your host, Jon Patch.
And welcome to Talkin' Pets, heard coast to coast on your favorite radio station. This is Talkin' Pets, and I'm your host, Jon Patch. Joining us is animal expert
Leigh Toborowsky,
here to answer your training questions, your first aid questions, and if you have those small exotic animals like spiders or chinchillas or fish or turtles, pick up the phone and give us a call. 866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255. The show is produced by Miss Amanda Page.
Hey there, Johnny boy.
Hi, Mandy.
Hi.
The show is also produced at Business Talk and Lifestyle Talk Radio by Mr. Mark Weber. So when you call in, you'll speak with Mark, and he'll put you on the line with us. 866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255. Pick up the phone, give us a call. We'll have trivia in this hour. You can win a bottle of Pet-tastic Naturals, 100% natural, the number one stain and odor remover in the country, Pettastic.com, as well as Uncle Norman's Pet Bath Sponge. All you need is your pets and water. 866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255. I'm Jon Patch.
And I'm Leigh Toborowsky.
And Amanda Page.
And this is Talkin' Pets.
Talkin' Pets. We'll be right back after a short pause. Well, four to be exact.
Pets are part of the family, and when traveling with your dog, there's only one magazine to include when packing your doggy's duffel bag, and that's Fido Friendly, the travel and lifestyle magazine for you and your dog. Each bi-monthly issue includes hotel, city, and state reviews, and doggy destinations to explore with your furry companion. Fido Friendly magazine can be found at Borders, Barnes & Noble, PetSmart, Pet Boutiques, and Fido Friendly hotels nationwide. Or you can go online to subscribe at www.fidofriendly.com. So get traveling with your pet today and leave no dog behind. And remember, Fido Friendly's the only magazine dedicated to the travel lifestyle of man's best friend and the one magazine your dog will thank you for.
Coast to coast and around the world, it's All Behave with Arden Moore. Find out why cats and dogs do the things they do and get the latest buzz from wagging tongues and tails in Rin Tin Tinseltown. From famous pet experts and best-selling authors to television and movie stars, you'll get great tail-wagging pet tips and have a fur-flying fun time. All Behave with America's pet edutainer, Arden Moore. Every week on demand, this is the place for a special paparazzi treat. Only on PetLifeRadio.com. Let's talk pets on PetLifeRadio.com.
And once again, you're listening to Talkin' Pets. I'm Jon Patch.
And I'm Leigh Toborowsky.
And I'm Amanda Page.
And that's Kelly Clarkson.
Yes,
she's got a new CD coming out on March 10th, which is pretty cool. I'm looking forward to that.
Tuesday.
And actually, My Life Would Suck Without You. It would. But anyway, I mean,
my life would suck without you, John.
See? It would.
It would.
You wonder. Aww. You wonder why that's a number one song now, because, you know, Kelly Clarkson, actually, that's her single that she released off of the CD, and it's, like, on top of the charts.
Right.
Because we all know. Y'all in America, your life would suck without us.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes.
Don't forget it.
And thanks for listening to us on Talkin' Pets.
We appreciate it.
We do. 866-606-TALK. 866-606-8255. Pick up the phone, give us a call if you're open. We're open, actually, to your first aid questions, your training questions, your behavior questions, and if you have those small exotic animals, of course, we are open to that as well. So pick up the phone, give us a call, 866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255. We will have trivia in this hour. If you answer it correctly, we're going to send out to you a bottle of Pettastic Naturals, as well as Uncle Norman's pet bath sponge. By the way, if you want to check us out on the webcam and chat with us on there, if you're afraid to talk on the telephone, which most people do these days.
Yes.
But if you want to chat with us on there, you can do so at our webcam at talkinpets.com, no G in the talkin, or myspace.com/talkinpets. Click on the dog watching TV, and you can watch us. And like I said, I will have trivia in this hour. By the way, I like to do this like little history trivia with Amanda and Leigh, and see if they can get it correct.
Oh boy, here we go, Amanda.
Because I cannot ask you pet trivia because y'all know the pet trivia. And by the way, I do want to mention Spring Ahead tonight.
Yes, Spring Ahead.
Spring
we
Ahead.
Lose an hour.
Yep.
I want to fall back. I like the extra hour of sleep.
Yeah, I know.
But you get an extra hour of light.
Of daylight,
I do
which
like
is nice.
That.
Yeah, so at 2 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, Spring Ahead.
Yes.
So
woo-hoo.
It'll be 3 o'clock then, so you lose an hour of sleep. But anyway, history question. During the French Revolutionary Wars, France declared war on Spain in what year?
Oh, boy.
It's not a multiple choice?
No. Do you want me to give you multiple choice? Would that make it easier?
Yes.
Sure.
1792, 1793, or 1794?
1793.
1792.
Lee's right.
Yay!
1793. And what do you get out of that, Amanda?
That I hated history.
Yeah.
And I was thinking 1792, something sailed the... I'm saying no more.
But,
okay, move on.
But aren't you supposed to be mean to yourself right now?
Oh, come on. For
right.
All right, fine.
You know, someday I gotta learn ventriloquism. You'd make a great dummy.
Yep, oh, yep,
boy.
That's about right. All right, let's move on. What's the next one, John?
In what year Alexander Graham Bell received a patent for his telephone?
Oh.
Multiple choice, please.
I don't think Leigh needs multiple choice. She might know it.
Yeah, I think
she apparently liked history.
1872. 1890.
Oh, he's cheating!
No, I'm not. And you?
1994.
Oh, whatever. You're just sad.
What is it?
Alexander Graham Bell received a patent for his telephone in 1876.
Oh, I was so close the first time.
You
don't
you don't get no ding, ding, ding on that.
Dummy.
I grew up in Edison,
that's more
New
like
Jersey.
It.
Oh, my goodness, and you didn't know that.
I know.
Okay.
Well,
celebrity birthdays out there, TV personality Willard, I just thought he told us who was 100, Scott, is 75 years old. Willard Scott is 75 today. And football
Actually,
Hall of
that's
Famer.
Pretty good for 75.
Pittsburgh Steeler Franco Harris is 59.
What is that?
I don't know. Pittsburgh Steeler guy.
Yeah, that's a Bobby.
It's a Bobby fan.
Mm-hmm.
866-606-TALK, 866-606.
We only have two?
8255, yep, today.
What's his problem? Long stories and not enough info.
Right.
I have something to have a beef with him.
Okay, pet trivia, this isn't for you guys.
Okay,
this is for everybody listening.
Thank goodness, but see, we could answer these questions.
Yeah, that's the whole thing.
But if you get it right, we're going to send out to you a bottle of Pet-tastic Naturals, which this stuff is awesome.
I want some of that, too. That bottle rocks.
You've got it coming out to you. Yeah, it's now clear bottles. It's clear.
I know, and it sprays.
And it's in green.
I
meaning
love it.
Earth-friendly.
Yeah,
it looks like
it's
you
awesome.
Could drink it.
Yeah.
If you're on the webcam right
I don't
now,
recommend
you can actually
that, though.
See it.
Yeah, you can see it.
What it looks like,
Pet-tastic
Actually,
naturals.
You can see it because it's clear.
Yeah. See, I'm
the
holding it.
The packaging looks the same, a little bit the same, the
it's
logo.
TalkinPets.com or myspace.com/TalkinPets. Click on the dog watching TV and you can watch us.
It doesn't look like your standard animal cleaner. Poo cleaner.
Exactly.
But I'll tell you,
nice.
Poo cleaner. That's nice.
What? It'll clean anything.
Your poo cleaner.
Well, you know, I have to tell you something. Albert, he is a little spiteful pooer, and that's what it's for.
Spiteful pooer.
Hey, I'll tell
he
you.
He is.
I mean, my cats, I mean, hairball hell with these two.
Right?
I mean, and this stuff takes it right out no matter what they do the hairball on.
Yeah, and for cats,
and you,
it's
and
a
you
big
know,
deal.
When they have a hairball, I mean, if they've eaten their food before they get that hairball out, not only a hairball comes out, but a bunch of food as well. So
lovely.
It's nasty, but this stuff, the Pet-tastic takes
it
right out.
Oh, look, you really made Snowy feel bad. He's getting up. He said, I have enough of this.
I'm shocked that he's been laying there next to you the whole time.
I know. He's being Mr. Social. Bye, guy.
There he goes. He's running through the studio right now and wobbling into the other room. Okay, trivia question. The blood of a mammal is what color, guys?
Wait, John.
What? Oh, okay.
Well, when it hits air, we know it's red.
Okay, here we
Inside
go.
Inside the body, it is not.
It was a little louder than usual.
Okay.
Okay, so the blood of a mammal is...
Red.
Right. What is the what color is the blood of an insect?
Oh, I know this.
Ew, think about it. What does it look like when the bug hits your windshield?
You get... That's actually kind of good. You get a bottle of Pet-tastic Naturals, and you get Uncle Norman's Pet Bath Sponge. The blood of a mammal is red. The blood of an insect is what color? 866-606-TALK. And it's not no shade of, like...
Yuck.
You know...
It's the color of yuck.
We just gave you the answer. Think about the last time a bug hit your windshield.
866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255. Oh, by the way, guys, if you're going to the movies this weekend, you know I do movie reviews as well, and you can check them out on my website at TalkinPets.com, no G in the Talkin, or MySpace.com/TalkinPets. The top five movies as of last weekend, Tyler Perry's Madea Goes to Jail was number one. Number two, the Jonas Brothers, the 3D concert. Number three, Slumdog Millionaire.
Actually, it is.
Yeah, it's like it yeah. really went up there. It's coming out on DVD, though, too, and it's still doing well at the theater since right. it won all those Oscars. And then number four, Taken, which I heard is an absolutely phenomenal film. I heard it's really good. And number five, He's Just Not That Into You.
Right? I want to see that.
I'm used to hearing that. but, and I did actually go and screen Watchmen this week, and... If you want to sit through a non-Titanic film, then go see Watchmen. Two hours and 40 minutes long. Jeez. A little bit too much. It's very graphic.
Which?
There's a lot going on in Watchmen. It's too much going on.
Really?
Too many characters to keep up with. The writing was like so-so. The acting was okay. Even the fight scenes were like all right. But there were some things that they showed that they shouldn't have. And especially like in The Blue Man... You girls would like this. You know that Blue Man? Did you ever see
yeah.
the trailer for it? Totally nude throughout the whole thing.
I'm in.
I was shocked.
Sparked my interest.
Yeah. I mean, here's this thing walking around all blue color and everything, and they don't hide a thing.
It's blue?
It's blue.
It moves around.
I don't know about it moves around. Listen to you.
I mean, it's just naked.
Just use your imagination. He's fully nude throughout the whole film. Only like two or three times does he wear a suit.
Does he wear
very short period, a suit, and he wears like a chastity belt or something for one period. But he is nude. And Patrick Wilson, who's from Tampa, our hometown, is also nude in this film.
Oh. Nice.
So if you're into nudity, you might like Watchmen. But for the movie itself, it's 2 hours and 40 minutes long. And
that is a long
It's not horrible,
movie.
But they could have cut it shorter. I mean, they could have done a lot more things. 866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255.
Right.
Oh, they got enough, all right. And when the big blue man goes big, like a monstrous character.
So does his.
Everything does.
I'm not saying anymore. Ooh, what did I just do? 866-606-TALK,
866-606-8255.
Pick up the phone, give us a call. We're going to go to your calls. And we want to talk to you. We're going to go out to Les in Myrtle Beach, and we've got, I think, some trivia guessers out there as well. So don't go away. We'll be right back. We're going to take a little break, but we're going to continue on with Talkin' Pets. Once again, I'm Jon Patch.
And I'm Leigh Toborowsky.
I'm Amanda Page.
The trivia question is, the blood of mammals is red, but what color is the blood of an insect? 866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255. And by the way, we'll do it this way right now because everybody's going to hold over a break. Everybody who's holding over the break for the trivia question, stay in line, and we'll give you also a trivia that you can take a stab at and win Pet-tastic. Once again, give us a call, 866-606-TALK. Check out our webcam, TalkinPets.com or MySpace.com/TalkinPets. Click on the dog watching TV, and you can watch us. This is Talkin' Pets.
We'll be right back, right after these messages. Stay tuned.
Hey, ready to take a walk? Not just you, but the whole family. It's the 2009 Whisker Walk, Sunday, June 7th from 11 to 3 at the Lancaster Fairground in Lancaster, Massachusetts. Pet owners and animal lovers walk to lend a paw to benefit the animal shelters and pet charities they love. Come see exhibits, demonstrations, educational programs, special attractions, product giveaways, entertainment, auctions, raffles, food, fun, and things for adults and kids to see, do, and buy, both human and pet-related. Whisker Walk 2009, a fun day for everyone. For more information, log on to whiskerwalk.org.
Ladies and gentlemen, Pet Life Radio proudly presents DSPN, the Dog Sports and Performance Network. Get ready to unleash the dog sports enthusiast in all of us
From speed drawing and mushing to racing, agility, and competition, this is the place to learn all about the dog sports and activities that you can do with your furry best friend and canine competitor. So get ready for game time. DSPN with your host, Lori Williams. Every week, on demand. Only on PetLifeRadio.com.
Let's Talk Pets on PetLifeRadio.com.
Now, is it ABBA or ABBA?
ABBA.
Mandy?
ABBA.
Such a happy song. Puts you in a good mood. Once again, you're listening to Talkin' Pets. I'm Jon Patch.
And I'm Leigh Toborowsky.
And I'm Amanda Page.
And we're going to go to your calls and questions. And everybody holding on for trivia, stay online. We're going to give you all trivia questions, see if you can win. But right now, real quick, we're going to go out to the first caller, which is Les in Myrtle Beach.
Yes.
South Carolina has a quick question for you on iguanas. What's your question there, Les?
Yeah, I've got an iguana. He's 10 years old.
Nice.
And he's a green iguana.
Uh-huh.
And I say it's a he because he's got a purple head, so I assume he's a male. His spikes, on the tip of his spikes, is starting to get like you need to be cut off like with a finger clip nail. Is that due to some sort of food deficiency? I use a spray vitamin mineral supplement on his food.
How long have you had him?
10 years.
You've had him the whole 10 years?
Yes.
And
he was a little, he's about 6 inches long when I got him.
Okay, and how big is he now, about 5 feet?
4.
4 feet, okay. And it doesn't go by a purple head, to male or female.
Oh,
it really,
okay.
If you look at a dewlap underneath, I don't know if you're watching. Can you see us on the webcam right now?
No, I can't.
Okay, because I would show you by picture, I would describe this.
Well, it's not really important what sex he or
well,
she
well,
is.
There's a reason I'm asking you.
Okay.
There is a reason. But anyway, the vitamin mineral spray is okay. Really, you want sun, direct sunlight outside. Does he get or she to get direct sunlight from the actual sun?
Not until the summertime.
Okay. That might be why.
Oh, okay.
It
so
could
it's just
be
a matter
metabolic
of being
bone
in,
deficiency.
In
so what do you do in the case
winter?
Of that?
What you need to do is go to your local pet shop and get a UVA, UVB long tube bulb.
Just like for an aquarium.
Not for an aquarium.
It's specific
it's a long
for a
tube
reptile.
Specific for reptile because
for a
aquarium
reptile.
Lights only have UVA.
Okay.
And they have a plastic cover that covers them before the light goes into the aquarium. A reptile light is not going to have a cover going from the light to the animal. So
okay.
Do you have a screen on top of the cage or whatever
yes,
he's in?
Yes, there is.
Okay, good. So there's not glass or plastic or anything?
No, it's just
excellent.
Screen, a wire screen.
Okay, good. So you want, the rule of thumb is if water can flow through it, then UVB can go through it.
Okay.
You want UVB rays, not just UVA rays. And that's
okay.
What I think might be the issue.
Okay, well.
Okay.
That's good. Thank
yes,
you.
And get some Herbivite. It's a vitamin. Go to your local pet store. Describe
yep.
What's happening. You need a powdered supplement as well as the spray.
Okay.
Okay?
Les, try that out and let us know how you make out there in Myrtle Beach.
I will. Thanks.
Thanks, Les.
Bye.
That's Les doing his education
yes.
On, you know, exotics because
yes.
That's what people need to do.
Early morning sun is the best calcium vitamin D3 that turns into calcium for the bones of reptiles.
We've got Sue out there, and Sue is in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Sue, you're going to take a stab at the blood of mammals is red, but what color is the blood of an insect?
Yellowish green.
I'm going to say this because, I'll say, okay, I'll go with that. The yellowish green's okay. It's actually yellow, but it could have a hint of green in there. So,
it's
but
gross.
You did say yellowish, so we'll make you a winner on that. Petastic Naturals
is
coming out to you, which is all new and earth-friendly. And we're going to send out to you Uncle Norman's Pet Bath Sponge.
Thank you.
Congratulations,
good job.
Sue. That's Sue out there in Green Bay. Stay on the line. Speak with Mark, and he'll get your information. We'll ship that stuff out to you. And we've got, holding on, Dan in Las Vegas. Dan, you there with us? Hello, Dan.
Yes, sir.
Dan, the blood of a mammal is red. The blood of an insect, as we just learned, is yellow.
Correct.
What is the blood of a lobster? What color?
Ah. that's interesting.
Oh, now see, that's a good one. You know, it's been so long since I've been able to afford lobster.
well, you are in this economy now, aren't we?
Yeah, you know, I'm going to guess, and this is just a guess, that it is almost clear.
What are you, stoned or stupid?
Sorry there, Dan. That is incorrect, but you can try again on another trivia question. Thanks, Dan. That's Dan in Las Vegas. We got hold on real quick. We got Ed out there in Schuylerville, Indiana. What do you think, Ed? What color is the blood of a lobster? What do you think? Take a stab at that one. Not literally, but what do you think, Ed, in Indiana? What color is the blood of a lobster?
It would say blue.
Congratulations.
Wow, very good.
We are going to send out to you a bottle of Petastic Naturals. That's coming out to your door. Stay on the line and speak with Mark. We'll get your information there in Indiana and ship out the Petastic. And congratulations.
All right.
Color of a lobster's blood is blue. So
that's pretty
thank you.
Mammals is red.
Blue
insects
blood.
Is yellow. Lobsters, as Ed just told us, in Indiana is blue. Once again, this is Talkin' Pets.
Talkin' Pets news from the USA Today. Live from the ranch, here's your host, Jon Patch.
In Corvallis, Oregon, about 125 volunteers showed up over the weekend at the William L. Finley National Wildlife Refuge to cover a hillside with a variety of plants that will create habitat for the Fender's blue butterfly when the endangered insect is reintroduced soon to the area. The species is found only in the Willamette Valley, mostly in Benton County. Leigh?
This is in Oxford, Maryland. The eastern shore is lucky to see one snowy owl every 4 years or so. But this year alone, at least four have been spotted, drawing bird watchers from all over. Snowy owls are sensitive to food supply, and the supply crashes periodically, forcing them to fly south to find sustenance. John?
Out of Cleveland, Ohio, an environmental evaluation found improvement in a river so polluted 40 years ago that it's famously caught fire. Now, the Cuyahoga, I think that is, river is still not healthy in several ways, including too much algae and too many fish with tumors and other deformities. According to the United States Environmental Protection Agency, the fire in 1969 involved oil and floating debris. Leigh?
Lahana, Hawaii. A humpback whale in a research boat collided off the coast of Maui, knocking a woman to the deck. The whale surfaced from below the vessel, the Hakulanu, and the 61-year-old victim for Brockhamerton, Washington, banged her head when she fell. Police say she was conscious and alert when the ambulance arrived. John?
Where was that out of?
That was very hard to say.
Where was that out of?
Bremerton, Washington is where the woman was from. The boat was called Hakulani, but it was out of Lahana, Hawaii.
Don't you feel like you're drinking sometimes when you got to say those names?
Yes.
Out of Springfield, Missouri, since January, the state agriculture department has seized more than 1,100 dogs statewide.
Wow.
About twice as many as in January and February of 2008. Action has been taken against 23 Missouri breeders this year. An agricultural department spokeswoman said the weak economy may mean fewer people are buying dogs, leaving breeders' kennels more crowded. Once again, you're listening to Talkin' Pets. I'm Jon Patch.
And I'm Leigh Toborowsky.
Pick up the phone, give us a call, 866-606-TALK. That's 866-606-8255. We want to talk with you. You can check us out on the webcam at TalkinPets.com or MySpace.com/TalkinPets. Click on the dog watching TV, and you can watch us. 866-606-TALK. This is Talkin' Pets. Amanda, would this be appropriate?
Good dreams of you at night.
Appropriate?
Instead of the other thing?
I had another idea, too, but you didn't give me enough notes.
You want to just go with this?
Sure.
Okay, we'll just talk to Leigh for a second, okay?
Okay.
What's up? So, Leigh, how's your day?
It's going just dandy.
Isn't the weather just lovely?
Oh, my gosh. It was like 81 degrees today. It was magnificent down here.
And the sun was shining.
It was
beautiful. And the breeze.
Absolutely beautiful.
To be able to go to the beach today would have been incredible.
What is this?
Happy birthday, baby.
Thank you. I love Carvel. Thank you, John. Thank you, Amanda.
That was our
that's all Johnny Boy.
That was our little surprise to Miss Leigh.
Ah, I have a surprise birthday cake. And I didn't even get a birthday cake last week.
Really?
No.
Well, there you go.
I actually
and
got a birthday cake.
And it's ice cream.
I love
Who
it.
Who doesn't love ice cream?
I cannot believe I got a birthday cake.
How soon until we get some?
That's up to Miss
Leigh. We can eat it right this second. I'm all into eating this
Bobby
cake right
now. Bobby is
going
to be jealous.
We can wait till Bobby gets here. Because the cake is better when it melts a little tiny bit because it's too hard.
As long as it doesn't melt too much, like our melting fudgy the whale.
Yeah, no, not too much.
Leigh and I are both Pisces.
Yes, we are Pisces. Your birthday is like in a week, 10 days from today.
10 days, not fun. St. Patrick's Day.
And actually, I will have to say, my grandmother would have been, today is her birthday, she would have been 95 today. May she rest in peace.
When did your grandmother pass?
She passed away 10 years ago. This past December 27th.
Yeah, my dad just passed. It's a year now that my dad passed away 2 days ago.
Mm-hmm.
It's, you know, it's tough.
Yeah, it's very tough. It's been 10 years, but still, it feels like yesterday.
None of us live forever.
No, and my grandmother, they always say that I got my love of nature and animals from Gam.
That's the interesting part about, I mean, you know, I just feel like we don't appreciate life anymore because we're all so busy.
Right.
We're also worrying about, you know, the economy and how we're going to pay our bills. And, you know, it's like, what happened to the days when you'd sit there and have dinner with mom and dad and,
you know,
as a family? And, you know, it's
just, so true.
Things have changed so drastically for the worse.
I mean, when I was growing up, we sat around the table. My grandmother, who was, my maternal grandmother, so it was my mom's mom, she would visit us. She was from West Virginia, but she would visit us almost 6 to 9 months every single year out of the year. So really, I grew up with her. She sat at the table and ate with us. We grew up together at the table. And, you know, my grandmother was the type, she took her time with everything, eating everything. And that's the thing.
Nobody takes their time anymore.
And literally look at flowers. When I say stop and smell the roses, that proverbial saying, we went to Epcot once. I went with my uncle and my grandmother. And you know how Epcot has flowers everywhere. Topiaries, flowers. It's magnificent. You know, Walt Disney World. It's amazing. It took us so long to get through Epcot. I don't even think we did half of Epcot that day because Gam stopped and looked at every single flower there was.
So the moral to this story is
appreciate
stop
the
and
beauty.
Smell the roses.
Stop and smell the flowers, the roses, everything, because that's what life's about.
You know, we do. We take it for granted anymore. And it's not that, some of us are not taking it for granted purposely. It's just that we forgot to slow down.
It's scary.
It is scary. And it seems to be the way the world is going.
I know. And it's a different, it's a different age. And on that same note, I mean, talking about animals and the economy, shelters are having a rough time because people are losing their homes, foreclosures. They're inundated with animals, people that love their pets and don't know what to do with them. And because
of that,
they can't afford to take care of them. And the donations across the board, not just humane societies, not just ASPCAs, every charity is down on donations. And it's very difficult right now.
866-606-TALK is our number to call. 866-606-8255. I'm Jon Patch.
And I'm Leigh Toborowsky.
Amanda Page.
Happy birthday, Leigh.
Thank you, Jon.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, Amanda. And we're going to dig into a Carvel.
Woohoo! Stoner gets stupid. With a Talking Pets news brief, I'm Amanda Page. A 20-year-old in Nebraska is facing animal cruelty charges after stuffing his kitten inside a bong. Acre Shoemaker said his cat named Shadow just needed some time to mellow out. Shadow is recovering in an animal shelter. Sheriff deputies found the 6-month-old kitten taped inside a makeshift bong as it was being smoked. The bong is made of plexiglass about the size of a shoebox. Deputies were looking for the 23-year-old Shoemaker. He was wanted on a warrant for possession of marijuana. Go figure. They found him in his home, and they say he was smoking the bong. Shoemaker told deputies the kitten was high-strung. He says he put it in the bong to keep it calm. Humane Society officials did x-rays and other tests to see if the kitten was or has any long-term effects from the alleged abuse. Police said Shoemaker told them he had done this several times. They say they're working with the sheriff's office and the county attorney to get custody of the animal so it can be put up for adoption. Shoemaker has been released from jail after paying a $400 fine. He faces drug and misdemeanor animal cruelty charges. Reporting for Talking Pets, I'm Amanda Page.
See the kitty smoking.
Good work, John. I asked for a smoking song, and you got me a smoking song.
Kitty's getting down.
Very mellow. I don't recommend that you do that to your kitty.
No.
There are consequences.
That guy get beaten with a little Louisville slugger.
With a what?
A little
Thank you, Carrie
slugger.
Underwood.
Right. Idiot.
I love this music. Where the heck
this
did you find this?
I think this is Charles Schultz from like Peanuts or something.
Ren and Stimpy.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay. That's
it's called,
Ren and
it's
Stimpy
called
one.
Smoking.
Yeah, because the guy is an idiot. He's in you-know-what hole.
Meow. Meow.
And once again, you're listening to Talkin' Pets. I'm Jon Patch.
And I'm Leigh Toborowsky.
I'm Amanda Page.
We all mean it in fun.
Yes, that poor kitty. Yeah. Really and truly.
People like that need to be strapped down. And well, that's another story.
That's what I'm talking about.
866-606-TALK. 866-606-8255. I'm going to put out a trivia question for you. If you get it right, we're going to send you out a bottle of Petastic Naturals.
Natural.
If you can get this trivia question.
Okay.
Should I go with that one?
Yeah.
You think so?
That's a good one.
Okay, we want to know, this breed of dog is the only animal whose evidence is admissible in an American court.
Very good one.
What breed of dog? 866-606-TALK.
I know.
866-606.
And I didn't cheat.
8255. You know the answer. We're going to send you out a bottle of Petastic Naturals. So pick up the phone. Give us a call. You know, Miss Leigh, you were talking about, you know, like nonprofit organizations and
yes.
fundraisers and stuff like that, you know, like shelters and all in need of
yes.
support. There's another organization which are friends of mine, actually. It's called BAC, B-A-A-C, and it's Bikers Against Animal Cruelty. And for all the Connecticut listeners, I mean, they do fundraisers all around the country,
right.
all around America. But this one just happens to be in the state of Connecticut, and it's called Two Wheels for Two Wheels.
Cool.
It's a fundraiser to take place on March 21st at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and it's in Connecticut, actually. And it's at the Airport Road Cafe in Hartford, Connecticut.
Okay.
So if you're in the area on March 21st, you want to help out the bikers. They're all doing it for the animals.
Very cool.
It's at 1 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time at the Airport Road Cafe in Hartford, Connecticut. So give them a hand. 866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255. That's the number to pick up the phone and give us a call about your pets. You know, you've got a background in exotic pets, and you deal a lot
mm-hmm.
with them, not only dogs and cats and everything like
right.
that, but, you know, with the exotics. But I want to ask you a couple of questions about, you know, some exotic pets that some people may have, and one I want to talk to you about is a tarantula.
Yes.
And but first we're going to go out to Stephanie, and she's in Lewiston, Idaho. She has a stab at that trivia question and see if
okay.
she can get a bottle of Petastic Naturals. Stephanie, what do you think? Now, this breed of dog is the only animal whose evidence is admissible in an American court. What breed?
Well, I'm thinking it's a German Shepherd.
I would say that you are...
Good guess, though.
Incorrect. But
okay,
that was
so
a good guess.
How about that?
You only get one guess.
You only get one guess, Stephanie.
I'm sorry.
Sorry, I don't know what...
We appreciate
I think Mark killed off Stephanie.
Wow, and you think I'm harsh.
Mark was like, no, one guess only. You can try out another trivia question, though, Stephanie. We're going to try Tom out there, and Tom is in North Myrtle Beach, and he's going to take a stab on that as well. What do you think, Tom?
Bloodhound.
I would say...
Good job.
Congratulations. We're going to
okay.
send out to you a bottle of Petastic Naturals. This stuff is guaranteed to take out anything. It is absolutely unbelievably
it
awesome.
Is.
And this one is actually the Naturals that we have. So we're going to send that out to you. So congratulations. Stay on the phone and speak with Mark, and we'll get your address there in Myrtle Beach and ship that out to you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. That's Tom. And the only breed of dog that is admissible in the state of American court is the Bloodhound.
The Bloodhound.
It's funny because, you know, when we were talking about it, German Shepherd, of course, like Stephanie said, we were thinking, yeah, German Shepherd.
That was my first guess, actually, Stephanie.
But the Bloodhound is it, though.
Bloodhound.
So... Well, congratulations to Mr. Tom in North Myrtle Beach, but I want to talk to you real quick about the tarantula.
Yes.
Is that a popular pet?
You know, actually, it is a popular pet. There's a lot of different types. There's different species of tarantulas. Some are more aggressive than others. Some get much bigger than others. The striped knee tarantula you see most often in the pet
trade. Named after the stripe on its knee?
Obviously. It's also really? A somewhat medium-sized tarantula, but it's less aggressive. You also see a rosehair tarantula. That's the other one. They're a lot less aggressive than, let's say, an orange baboon tarantula, which is bright orange, very flashy in color.
Where's the baboon coming?
It sounds a little aggressive.
It's an aggressive tarantula, and it's not really good to keep in captivity because it is aggressive. It's definitely better for not a beginner, but a more, you know, not a novice.
How long do they live, like a tarantula in general?
Tarantulas can live, you know, it depends on the tarantula, but they have a lifespan maybe, you know, it depends on the tarantula.
The weird part is I just don't see that as being like a pocket pet.
It's not a pocket pet. You don't put a tarantula in your pocket.
Well, I
their
heard that.
Their abdomens are very, very,
very
delicate.
I heard that.
Right. So that you have to, they have to feel that they have, you know, they have soft underbellies. They have to feel safe.
And I heard if you drop them that they will
they
explode.
Die.
Basically,
right.
Their belly
would
just boop.
And that's why they have to feel safe in your hand. But they can live 5 to 10 years.
866-606-TALK. Once again, you're listening to Talkin' Pets.
Talkin' Pets. We'll be right back after a short pause. Well, 4 to be exact.
Greetings, human. What planet am I on?
Welcome to Pet Planet. Here's a copy of Pet Planet magazine, Florida's most informative and fun pet resource magazine. It features heartwarming stories and informative articles from local and national pet experts.
Excellent.
Pet Planet magazine offers Operation Planet Rescue, helping rescued pets find new homes. And it's available at 500 locations in South and Central Florida and 24/7 on the internet at petplanetmagazine.com. If you're out and about with your pet, you may be featured in Paparazzi, candid pictures of you and your pet. For up-to-date pet-friendly events, activities, and pet-related services and products, Pet Planet Magazine is your final destination.
I shall take this magazine home with me.
Back to your home planet?
No, to my condo in Boca.
Pet Planet Magazine. Check them out at www.petplanetmagazine.com or 352-394-8578. It's out of this world.
New York, the glitz, the glamour, the exciting Mutt-tropolis, the sparkling kitty city that never sleeps. Join us each week for Pets in the City with your host, Diane West. Celebrity pet sightings, hot events, and news and reviews with the hottest movers, shakers, and tail waggers in New York. So take a bite out of the Big Apple with Pets in the City every week on demand only on PetLifeRadio.com.
Let's Talk Pets on PetLifeRadio.com.
I love David Archuleta. I think he did a really good job, you know, on American Idol last year. And American Idol this year looks pretty good. I'm looking forward to some of these singers.
Yeah.
I think they picked a good group of kids. And the thing is that now they went 13. No,
did
12.
They?
They went 13.
I didn't know that.
Yep. The whole breaker the other night was the fact that, you know, they stopped it at 12 and everybody was like, a noop. That's his name, the guy. A noop.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody was like, why? How could he not make it in there? And all of a sudden, Simon says, well, we're mixing it up this year. There's 13. A noop, you're in.
Oh,
awesome.
Are you serious?
Tatiana didn't get in. Drama queen.
Really?
I like Tatiana. But how stupid can you be when you sing the same song 3 times?
Oh, she did?
She did, yeah. It was like,
hello.
They were looking for her to like perform and beat the other people, and then she sang the same song
again. That's the only song she knows, then.
Apparently.
What song is
it? She pretty much kind of said that. It was what's her name? Whitney Houston.
Oh, right.
Hard to sing a Whitney Houston song, but, you know, she did a great job on it. But
she practiced hard on one song and one song only.
Exactly.
Right.
3 times in a row. Real quickly, we had a caller off the air that had a question for you regarding hairballs. What's
hairballs?
A good remedy for a cat hairball?
Well, there's Petromol. There's different, you know, things you can get from your vet to aid in that.
You know what helps, though, too, is they do have, like, certain foods out there that you could feed your cats.
Right.
And I do that with my cats. What I have them on is a hairball remedy food. And it does prevent it. I mean, I have to admit, since I've been putting them on that food, very little on the hairballs. I mean, I don't
see
that. Yeah,
I mean, there's definitely essential fatty acids are good for skin, coat. You want to brush your cat, especially a long-haired cat. You want to brush your cat and groom the cat a lot.
Good point.
Very, very preventative measure there. Because the cat's grooming themselves, and that's why. And a Longford cat, obviously, is going to get more hairballs than a Shortford cat because the hair is longer. So if you groom the cat, when the cat grooms itself, it's not going to ingest most of that fur. But like you said, John, put them on a real good, healthy food, add essential fatty acids to the diet, and once a week you can get what's called Petromalt. There's different types. There's different products in the pet foods section. Go to the vet, whatever, and a ribbon, a one-inch ribbon, when it's in a tube, that's what it's called. You squish it, put it on the cat's nose, they'll lick it off, and it aids in digestion, it aids in hairballs.
As we close out this hour of Talking Pets, I wanted to mention, too, with the tarantulas, there's about, 800 different species out there that we know of.
Yeah, 800 different species,
and
right?
And you were saying the life expectancy of a tarantula is?
It depends. It's about 5 to 15, but really males are different than females. We were looking it up on the break just to make sure, because 800 species, obviously, in the wild, varies. In the wild,
but
they're going to live
a
shorter
female
life. Than in captivity.
Right.
Can
a
live
female
up to
can
30 years.
Right, that's a long time.
That's a long time.
Spider.
Right, I don't know anybody who's ever had one that long, but they can.
And a good diet for them is crickets, mealworms, moths, beetles, other small insects, and vitamin mineral supplements. Once again, this is Talkin' Pets. Spay and neuter your pet, help control that pet population. For myself, Jon Patch.
And Leigh Toborowsky.
Amanda Page.
And Mr. Mark Weber at Business and Lifestyle Talk Radio Networks. We say goodbye for Talkin' Pets.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
The opinions you hear on the Business Talk Radio Network are those of the hosts, callers, and guests, and not necessarily those of this station, Business Talk Radio Network, its management, or advertisers.
You're listening to PetLifeRadio.com.